All right, so projects. Illustrator projects. What we're going to do is we're going to come up with some ideas, or I'm going to list some ideas and you're going to come up with an even more awesome one. The first one, I suggest making it pretty easy so that you can knock it out in a couple hours, right? What you're going to do is you're going to come up with an ad slogan, or just an ad, right? Doesn't have to be super complex, but you're definitely going to want a slogan and a graphic and a company name. I don't really want you to go and find an existing, right? Here's what I would prefer you not to do. Apple Think Different ad, right? Don't come up here. All right, I'm going to recreate that one. Nah, that's pretty boring, right? Don't recreate an existing one. Come up with your own. I don't care if it's an existing company or whatever. You know, you could go and find, you know, an Apple logo and then come up with your own text and stuff like that. But I'd rather you kind of be creative. Come up with some imaginary company of your own, or go ahead and come up with an existing, you know, company name, but like a product that they haven't released, you know, the PlayStation 8 or something like that. But anyways, it's up to you. It's up to you to come up with whatever you want as an advertising slogan.
That one's cool. I like that one.
With a graphic and a company name. Right? All your ad's going to be. That's an idea. Or a magazine cover, right? It could be a real magazine. Don't duplicate a magazine, right? Don't go and find, you know, Rolling Stone with, you know, Bono on the cover, you know, and recreate it. Instead, you know, you can use an existing magazine template. If you go out and look, I am sure that you can find, just a moment, I'm sure that you can find, you know, magazine Rolling Stone logo, you know, you could find that and bring it into your project. That'd be totally cool. Or Time Magazine or whatever. But you know what a magazine cover looks like. So, you know, you don't have to use an existing one. You can come up with your own magazine, imaginary magazine, you know, something that you'd like to read if it really existed.
I had a bunch of boys like books, magazines before.
Yeah, so, you know, like Time, Rolling Stone, you know, your own. I like your own best. That's my choice. I'd rather you make up your own.
Are these ideas or project one and project two?
Well, project one, that's my best suggestion. But remember where it says pick, you know, do one of three? You're going to do one idea each time. That's probably the easiest. Feel free to do as your project one.
Real quick question.
Mm-hmm.
Can I be able to use my images I took from my camera?
Yeah, if that makes sense, right? I mean, you know, magazine cover, photograph, cool deal, sounds good. How about an album cover? Don't just duplicate Dark Side of the Moon, right? You know, come up with your own idea.
Hey, I
don't care if it's an existing artist, right? You know, you want to do Rihanna, but come up with your own, you know, album picture. You know, go and Google Rihanna. I don't care. Bring a picture in, you know, or make it abstract art or whatever.
Yeah, I can make my own.
Yeah, you know, or, you know, game art. You know, like a PlayStation box. Something like that.
I'm good with that.
The Play Box. The Play Box 2000. I'm kidding.
PlayBox
right.
2000, I would love that.
PlayStation, Xbox game, whatever you can feel like doing. PlayStation? How's about, you know, it could be any product. You know, cereal, right? You know, cereal box art, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. It could be any product box. Or poster, right? It could be a poster. The suggestion that I got from the prior professor a decade ago is, what do you see, you know, life like in 50 years from now? And some people always came up with something really grim, you know, like post-nuclear war or whatever, you know, and some people came up with positive stuff.
I've made a poster before in graphic communications, and I still have the image for it.
Yeah, as long as it's something that you're creating in Illustrator, that's cool.
Did you go to the MoCA?
Yeah, I was using...
You know, you can wander around, if you're a member of a campus club, you know, the theater club or whatever, you can come up with a poster for them. That kind of stuff. That's 6 project ideas for 3 projects. Feel free to pick any of those 6, or if they all bore you, come up with your own ideas. Right? So, that makes sense? If you cannot come up with an ad, no shame, just text me and I'll give you a suggestion, right? You can, you know, I can come up with one for you, but I know that the vast majority of you would prefer to do your own. Does that kind of make sense? I'm going to upload this document, you know, so that when it says pick 1 of 3, you actually can pick one or come up with your own. That making sense, gang?
Yeah, yeah. Can I be able to use some characters from Google as an example for, like, games?
Well, yeah. I mean, like, you know, if it's going to be Sonic or Sonic 3000 or whatever, yeah, it's totally fine to, you know, bring in some. But I don't want it. Here's what I don't want. People bring in too much art. Right, you know, you Google up Pokemon. You go and you find a group picture of all the Pokemon, right? Okay, you grab that one. And put a game title on it, Pokemon the Revenge, right? And then you upload it and you say that it's video game art. That's really not very creative. Yeah, it might be okay for an ad slogan for the first one, but it's, you're going to want to try harder. The first project you can, you know, we don't know the product that well yet, right? So a picture with some text, that's enough. But for the other ones, like album art and, you know, video game art and stuff like that, you don't want to just bring in a huge picture, paste it there, put in a couple of words, and call it a project. If you do that, you know, I'm not going to be mad, but I am going to ask you to redo it. Is that making sense, gang? I think I heard a question back here, and I got busy talking. Sorry. Are there any more? Are we all good?
Answering my first.
Let's go on and do the lecture, if the project ideas are understood.
Yeah, I was gonna show you some of them.
I will later. Let's get to work on the first of the lectures that we're gonna do today. We'll see how many we're gonna do. There's one called Celtic Art, Tracing Celtic Art. Let me switch to student mode, make sure that I'm seeing the exact same thing y'all are seeing. All right, so if I go to assignments, yelling at me that chapter 1's overdue, no stress, just get it done. Like I said, it's just walking through the book, you know, select this tool, select that tool, select this object, that kind of thing. All right, and then undated assignments, well, I better put a date on it to make it pretty easy to find. But we're going to do A1, Tracing Celtic Art. All right, if you refresh the assignments page, it should be there with a due date up at the top. Or I guess just the home page. The home page takes us to the assignments, right? Or not. Anyways, you can find it on the assignments. Worst comes to worst, just do Control F or Command F and look for Celtic. There we go. Tracing Celtic Art. I'm not in student mode, so that's why it looks a little bit different. If you go in, you should see a doc that we're going to follow. There's an example of Celtic Art, if you don't know what Celtic Art is. I meant to upload another one. I wonder if I could upload it right now. I thought it was pretty cool looking.
This one kind of looks like a horse.
Exactly. All right, if you refresh that page, Uno Momento, you'll see a second piece of Celtic art in there as well. It's just the one with all the fancy artwork, right? This fancy knotwork. I know that you're familiar with the style, even if you haven't, you know, heard it called by that name, right? That one's pretty cool, too. Maybe it's a bit small. that would be okay. I'm not sure that one's too small. If you want to find your own, I don't want you to spend too much time doing it, but you can go to Google, type in Celtic art, switch to images, and then you're going to only want black and white. So tools, color, black and white. And don't choose something too complicated, right? You're going to want one with, like, you know, 10, 20 pieces to color, not... That one's a little bit ambitious, huh? I wouldn't do that one. Some of these are cool, but I wouldn't know how to color them. It needs to be... If they have gaps in it, it's not going to be possible to color them with our current level of knowledge. I think I'll choose this one. I think that's kind of cool. No, I won't, because it's all one piece, right? So once I drop color, it would fill it in, right? It would take like only one eyedropper. That's not too interesting. Maybe I'll just do the horse after all. I think I had another one that was a Celtic tree at one time uploaded. But so what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to click on one of those files and download it.
What if it's shaped like a triangle?
If you think you can color it, go for it. All right, so I downloaded Celtic Horse just because I know there's no gaps in it. I know that it's going to be a good one. It doesn't have too many pieces to color. It's not so simplistic that it's too boring. I'm going to run with that one. I'm just going to paste it into Adobe Illustrator rather than download it and place it, which is what the instructions may say. But I am going to open the instructions and make sure I don't go too far afield, even if I'm improvising. Why is it that when I click on tracingcelticart.doc, it's downloading the so-called GIF? Believe it or not, the person who invented the format wants you to call it GIF, even though it's GIF, graphics interchange format. Well, after we are done with the assignment, sure. And if you want to upload the original one, too, so that I can see what you started with, that'd be pretty neat. I might use that image, you know, in the future. Are you getting an error message when you try to download the Celtic art?
It was Celtic art, yeah. I don't know what I
Yeah, let's take a look now. I wish the walls were a little more soundproof. All right, once more with feeling, we go to assignments. Upcoming assignments, A1, Tracing Celtic Art. If I get the doc, is it going to actually give me the doc, or is it going to download the GIF? It's downloading the GIF again. I don't know why this particular one's giving me fits. Let me revise it.
There we go.
What? more. Assignments. Celtic art. TracingCelticArt.doc. You're going to give it to me, right? Yeah, all right. Okay, so if you click on assignments, grab it one more time, you'll get the Word file. You don't have to have the Word file, right? I'll help you with it. I'm going to go through it, but it's nice to have something to refer to. All righty, so tracing a rasterized image and live painting it. It seems like every version of Illustrator, they rename one of the options, so I'm hoping that they haven't renamed this one too much. But okay, so I'm going to create a new document with one artboard, do a save as, and call it Tutorial A1. Maybe you've already done this. You're ahead of me. So File, New. Art and Illustration. I'm just going to pick one of these. It looks like I have one called 1280 by 1024. You can always adjust the size. Fiery. Orientation's not going to matter. I only need one artboard. You can always add artboards to your drawing. The color mode doesn't really matter, but I always recommend creating it in RGB unless told otherwise. So I'm going to click Advanced Options, make sure RGB, which stands for red, green, blue, is chosen. I'm going to choose Create. Alrighty, and it's acting like I've never run it before, and it's reset all of my other menu options. Thanks, Illustrator. So, here what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back to the workspace that I switched to last week. I'm going to click on Window, Workspace, Essentials Classic. Just because I'm really used to having this dashboard full of options along the top. And I like having this palette of toolbars on the side, which actually just seemed to be off the screen since I switched to a lower resolution.
Am I just drawing it?
Nope. You're going to bring in one of the Celtic art pieces. You can download one of the ones, or you can go onto Google and find one. Why don't you just download one of the ones, right? So just grab the horse or the other one. So you can click on it. I'm not sure if that one's going to work very well. I'm going to paste it in and see if it'll work. No, I'm going to stick with the horse, the tried and true one that I've been using for years. So I downloaded the horse. I'm going to do edit, select all, edit, copy. And there's more than one way to put a file into Illustrator. But if you can copy and paste, I kind of recommend that. The reason I recommend that is because if you do it in another fashion and then send me the project, when I try to open the AI file, it may complain that I don't have your original file. Now, PDF, no problem. I'll be able to view the PDF. It'll work great. But if you can copy and paste, that's what I recommend. So I'm going to go into AI. I'm going to paste. It may be too large for my page. Whoa, it's quite sizable. No problem.
What exactly did you do? I'm sorry.
Do you see what? Okay, yeah, I went too fast over that. What I did is I went to assignments, I found the assignment called Tracing Celtic Art. I picked one of the images. There's two different ones. I think that this one kind of small and grainy, so I want the Celtic Art one. Did you see what I did? I just clicked on it, A1 Celtic Horse, saved it, and opened it. Are you at that point? You got a file? All right. And then you choose Edit, Select All, Edit, Copy.
I'm looking for select all.
So now I went to my Illustrator. I made a new project. I meant to save it immediately so I could keep saving it early and often so I wouldn't lose my work. So as soon as you make a project, it's a good idea to save it. So I'm just going to do Save As and call it Lecture A or Lecture A1. Yeah, A1, why not? It's assuming that we're going to do multiple today. Hope that's the case. And I need to put it in a place where I can find it later. I made myself a file off the desktop. Right, a folder off the desktop. I don't see it now, so I'm going to make it again. Do you see what I did? I clicked on desktop. I hope that option's there for you. I did new folder. Mult 1613. Click create. And now I'm just going to save my file, Lecture A1. Or maybe the Word document calls it short, right? Doesn't matter. File name doesn't matter as long as you get it uploaded to the correct folder. And then I don't care about changing any of the rest of these options. Now that I have a blank page, I'm going to do two steps and then I'm going to wander around and make sure everybody's going okay. Paste, it's too large. It's easy to fix that. Move your mouse, your cursor, make sure you're on the black cursor mode, to the corner and holding the shift key down, shrink it.
It's not allowing me to paste.
I'll come look, just a sec. All right, and heck, I'm gonna save it again just because that took a lot of work. So I'm gonna Command S, Control S to save it.
Yeah, I was following your steps.
Well, it looks like it's there.
It is there, yeah.
Okay, then we don't need to paste it. You already got it there. Good job.
That's why I clicked it.
Anybody else not got a document open? Okay, some people are way ahead. It's awesome if you feel like, to see how that one works.
The dog or whatever it is kind of pixelated. If you remember me talking last week about the difference between raster graphics, if I zoom in, I can see all the pixels. That's kind of nasty. I don't want to see that. I want it to be perfect. I want it to be made out of perfect lines. And that's what we're going to do next. Yeah, this showed a different series of steps, and it works just as well using the place command. All right, resize it. Now use the live trace tool to convert the image to a black and white logo. All right, I hope they left the same name. If you have it in Workspace Essentials, you ought to be able to choose this black cursor, pick your image. Okay, they changed its name from live trace to image trace. No biggie, we can handle that. And then from the down arrow next to image trace, choose black and white logo.
Wait.
So choose your drawing. Did you change your workspace? Do you have the good stuff up here at the top, the mask and the crop image and stuff like that? If you do not have this toolbar up at the top, wave your hand. I'll come help.
I don't know where you are.
Should I change back to the voice?
You can do whichever shape you want.
What I'm asking is if you have this thing on the top that I do, you don't. So you're going to go to Window, Workspace. Whoops. Too many clicks, too fast. Workspace, Essentials Classic. Does anybody else not have the mask and image trace options up at the top?
No, I did do what you said, but it made it look funky.
Sure, we want to stick with that. Let me show you how you can modify.
Yeah, I'm going to switch over to doing that one. just for a moment. Y'all don't need to switch, but I want y'all to see some options that you can mess with. Okay, the problem with this one is that apparently I downloaded a preview, so it's kind of lame, it's kind of small. When I paste it in and trace it, it may be too blocky. Let's see what the other one looks like. Yeah, okay, so when I stretch it out, it's too blocky, but I'm gonna try to trace it anyways. So I'm gonna come down here, I'm gonna click the pull down, choose black and white logo. Y'all with me? That didn't look too bad, but it's got some gaps in it. Maybe we can fix the gaps. What you gotta do to modify it, and sometimes you'll trace something and it'll disappear completely. Or sometimes you'll trace something and it'll be solid black or otherwise look lousy. So we got to change the tracing options. And it's not real obvious where that is. You see this little page here next to the view menu? Nice and subtle to make sure that, you know, we can't find it easily. Click that little page. And then you get some options. Like threshold. Dial that threshold back and forth and see how it changes it. I'll come right over there. So yeah, I might be able to get rid of the gaps that way.
Image tracing results.
Okay, let me show you again where that is. Make sure your shape is selected. Make sure that you've done the image trace black and white logo. And then next to tracing result, there's this little dialog that when you hover over, it says image trace panel. And you click that open, and you have this threshold slider. That's kind of cool in its own right. Basically, you just want to make sure that it doesn't have any gaps on it. I may go back to the horse, but that looks pretty good. I think that I got rid of all the gaps without it looking too lousy.
I got it like on 207.
Yeah, 193 looks okay to me. 203 looks good. Yeah, around there, it looks like any of that stuff is good, up in the 200 range. I think the horse did not require that. Once you have traced it, there's one more thing we got to do before we can start painting it. We got to click expand. Now I was expecting to see the expand option right up here at the top. I'm not seeing it, so I'm going to go under object. Oh, how about that? How about maybe I haven't traced it yet?
Yeah, that's what I did.
Okay, now once you trace it, there should be an expand option. Once you've adjusted the settings you want, the thresholds you want, and all that, then you ought to click expand. And now it is an Illustrator object. It's honest to goodness Illustrator. You can zoom in infinitely and all the jaggy pixels are gone. So you could send this to a printer and they could print it out at, 2,000 pixels per inch and it would still look good.
That is so cool.
Now we can colorize. I'm going to do the same thing to my skinny horse here. Dog, wherever he is. Dog, I guess.
Just a quick question. So, when I know this isn't part of the assignment, but I want to do it with him. It shows, different paths as I actually trace this. Is there a way to,
combine them all into one?
Yeah.
Try to select them all. See if you can come up to object.
Let's see what you draw.
Grouping them is one good thing, but we're going to actually need to make one object out of it. So go ahead and group them, sure. That's cool. And then object, path, see if there's a... Try and join first.
Color guide.
I may have to look it up. But play around with that. Play around with... I'm surprised that didn't happen. You're gonna have to see what happens when you colorize it. See how it works.
It looks groovy.
I'm just following your steps.
That's cool. All right. So, what's next on the agenda to actually start painting it? We need the live paint bucket, which they hid under the Shape Builder tool. The Shape Builder tool is the two overlapping circles. So, with this still selected, the Shape Builder tool is the one that looks like the two overlapping circles right there near the push pin.
Okay.
Click and hold on that until you see live paint bucket.
The live paint, you have to click and hold it. Yep.
And it looks like it only wants to paint in black and white. How do I know that? Because when I went over here and hovered over this, I only see a couple of colors up there. So I'm going to open up swatches so that I can see more colors. If you ever can't find a menu, a palette or anything, just go under Window, Swatches. Window Menu Swatches. Now we got a lot of colors. And if you ever need to change your palette, there's a whole bunch of libraries. That's all pastels. Apparently they think kids like pastels. I beg to differ. An early kid will always go for a bright primary color. So I'm going to choose green, and I'm going to move my paint bucket over here and give my thing a green background. And then I feel like zooming in. So I'm going to hold the control key the command key on your Mac, and I'm going to spin the mouse wheel up to zoom. Well, that's not zooming in. Make a liar out of me. Option. Hold the option key and spin up, and you get real close so that you can do fine color adjustments. Notice that when you're in the paint bucket mode, it's showing three colors. If you use the left and the right cursors, you can cycle through the colors.
I'm not zooming out.
Option key, spin in and out. Hold the option key and spin the cursor. I'll be right over. If you're working on your own, it may be because you got confused. Okay. Let me come look.
I am. There we go. I was way too close.
Yeah, that's cool.
How I did?
I like the triangle there.
Oh, jeez.
Now you're good to go. You always have to click the expand option after you do the live trace, so it's not an Illustrator object yet. Yeah, when you traced it, it brought in some garbage. That's a real drag. Zoom way in. Yeah. See what happens if you grab the black cursor and select that stuff. I wonder if we can even delete it. Like, if there are parts of your shape, when you traced it and it came in erroneously, there are little hacky bits and pieces on it, you might be able to grab the black cursor and delete. I'll be right there. Sorry, didn't mean to ignore you. You might be able to grab a piece of it and hit delete. Now, in this case, took care of everything. I don't want that. So I'm going to double click on the whole thing until I'm just editing the inside piece. Let me show you what I just did. This is a little bit more complicated than I meant to do, but when I'm looking at this document and I double click on a piece of it, it goes into what's known as isolation mode. I'm editing now just one group. I could ungroup everything, but I'm going to leave it grouped, and then I'm going to find some piece and I'm going to double click on it again, and double click on it again and again, and now you see I'm inside. As far as I can go, you can tell how far you are inside that object by this little menu up here. And then I could delete that piece if I needed to. When you're ready to get out of it, the easiest way to get out of an object, yeah, you can click on layer one and get all the way back out like that, but I just double click on the white background. That deselects everything. Okay, my drawing's looking pretty lame, but that's okay. I chose some bad colors. I'm not ashamed. All right, I'll come back there now.
Sorry, Elizabeth.
I think my line looks pretty good.
How do I deselect all of this?
Why does it view differently on yours?
I don't know, but pick a different library. Just look around and choose one.
Choose swatches and it's only showing black and white, very plausible, then you can open up a new library of swatches. If I'd come up and it only showed black and white in my swatches, I'd click on the little books here and choose default, swatches, art, and illustration. And then it gives me all my colors, right? I can use those.
It should be a lot to click on the triangle too, right? Like just the black lines?
Yeah, you should be able to change both the fill and the edge. I'm going to ungroup mine and see if it gives me more freedom in moving the pieces around. I can't say that it did.
Thank you.
right, I just spent 2 minutes frustrating myself. Let me show you the stupid user trick that I just did. I was in selection mode, and then I selected the object, and I clicked a swatch, thinking I was just changing one piece. Nope, I was changing the whole thing. You have to be in the live paint bucket mode for the individual colors to actually work. All right. You don't have to make it look pretty. You don't even have to fill in the whole thing. As long as you've proven that you know how to bring something in and trace it, that's totally cool.
At least I know how to make my logo a bit more better. You could bring that Photoshop picture in and try tracing it and see what it did. How did your drawing with your grouped pieces, did that ever start working?
Yeah, it worked. I just can't do the select colors now.
I found this is a really stupid idea, but if you'd taken a screenshot of your drawing, brought it in that way, and then traced it, it would be working now. Because you'd be bringing it in as a rasterized graphic, but that's a moronic way of doing it.
Could this kind of color work?
That's cool. Yeah, you can use gradients. You can use any kind of fill that you want.
Right? I don't have too many gradients here, but I could select my background here. And I could paint bucket it with, you know, like that. If you feel like.
Technology sucks.
That's cool right there, how you're doing that.
That was cool.
It's just like, you might have to wait, you hit W. Oh, that won't do anything.
My life is a living hell.
3 hours later.
I'm so jealous.
Okay, I'll give y'all a couple more minutes to play with it. It doesn't have to be finished. When you're done with it, I want you to save your work. Call it Lecture A1 if you haven't already given it a name. Looks like I didn't. I thought I did. It's probably going to give me an error saying that I've got two documents with the same name. I'm just going to call it A1 too. Stupid. Okay. And then also do a save as PDF. So do double save as when you're ready to upload it. Save as, make it an Illustrator file, and then do a save as again, and save it as a PDF. Now, I know I mentioned this last week, but it's frustrated me so much in the past that I'm going to mention it again. The newer versions of Illustrator, once you do save as PDF, you're now editing the PDF rather than the AI file. So any changes you make to this are no longer reflected in your original file. So the best thing to do at that point is just to close it. Then you can go back and open it again if you want. What we're going to do is I'm going to click back on assignments and go to B. So the new one we're going to work on is called Op Art Lines, Optical Art. one is optical art. Well, in the 70s, you'd buy posters like this, and you'd stare at them and feel really groovy. Stuff like this. Now, ours isn't going to look this cool, but kind of cool. I like that. I wish I could do this kind of stuff. Ours is going to be a little bit simpler. That's cool. Anyways, so going in there and opening instructions. Op art lines. We want the Word doc. There's no files. Otherwise, we're not going to be copying and pasting or anything like that. Okay, so creating an op art pattern with repeated lines. Here's kind of what we're going to make it look like. It's going to kind of look three-dimensional. So I'm going to create a new document, do a save as, call it short B or lecture B. And then I'm going to draw a line like that. So inside AI, create new. I'm going to save as.
In tabloid?
Well, I lost myself. How about that?
I lost myself as well because I was trying to catch up.
Okay, so going back in AI. I'm create new, and then I forgot to go over here and choose create. Yeah, and so it failed until I did that. Alrighty. Now I have my new page. And by the way, if you need to add more than one page, what they call an artboard to your illustration, like you're doing the front and the back of a magazine or something like that, there's an easy way to do that. Or if you need to resize your page, it used to look like a tic-tac-toe board. Now it's a page with a little crosshairs in the corner. It's near the magnifying glass. If you choose that, you can draw another page. Or you can stretch out one that you've already got, resize it. Now I don't need that, so I'm going to delete that. Okay, so I want to use the paintbrush tool. Underneath the diagonal line, if you're on Essentials Classic. I want it to be as thin a line as possible, so I'm going to go up to Stroke up here and lower the stroke down to like 0.25. I don't want it to have a fill at all. It looks like it has a fill, but that's actually a white fill. So I don't want a fill at all. So I'm going to click. Check this out, guys. If you're not watching, please do. You can change your stroke color here, like if I wanted to do red paint, but instead I'm going to do black. But the next one, the white one, I want to choose it so that it's got the red bar through it, meaning that it's got no fill whatsoever. Then with the paintbrush tool, I'm just going to draw, you don't have to go nuts, just some kind of squiggle. You know what, that was supposed to be 0.25. It wasn't. It changed it to 1 while I drew it. So I'm going to use the black cursor to select my curve, my path, and then I'm going to lower the point size of the stroke to 0.25. There, now it's thinner.
Okay. So really, you only need one line. If you drew a whole bunch of stuff on the screen, then it may just be a problem after that. Make sure you have one line, that you're ready, that it's got 0.25 points, that it's that thick. And now we're going to copy and paste it. But let's follow the instructions exactly so I don't go off the map. Here's what we're going to do. Instead of just copying and pasting it, we're going to use the object transform option. Object transform move. Now let me show you the wrong way to do it so that you don't do it the wrong way, because half the time I do this. Select the line, object, transform, move, type in some distance, and click OK. That actually moved it. I did not want to move it. There's a copy option as well. So I'm going to do it correctly now. Select your line with the black cursor.
I don't have one that says object on top.
You don't got a menu up at the top of the screen?
You're in still work. Click your
mouse. You got to be inside Illustrator. Select your shape,
transform.
Object, transform, move. You may as well choose preview so we can see what we're about to do. Now, I don't want it to jump up that far. I want to change these distances so that they're much smaller. I'll just read them off to you. 4 for vertical and 0 for horizontal. So 4 for vertical, 0 for horizontal. And you can pick which way you want it to go. I'm going to make mine just go like straight down or off to the side or something. Diagonally. And then choose copy. If you click move, it actually moves the whole thing, but we want 2 lines.
Did it say 4 PT distance?
If it says PT or PX, either is fine. All right, now I could keep doing that again. Object, transform, move, copy. Object, transform, move, copy, but that's kind of tedious. Instead, I'm going to go object, transform, repeat, or transform again. And I'll wander around and make sure that we're all good. Object, transform again, and notice that there's a control key that'll do that, Command-D or Control-D. And so I can just hit Command-D or Control-D to draw a whole bunch of them.
How many times do we need to do this?
Yeah, as many as you want. With Command-D, you know, it doesn't take any time to, like, put 20 or 30 copies down.
Command-D?
And then when you're done with that, just group them all, right? Select them all with the black cursor and group them. Why do you want to group them? Because if you try to move it otherwise, you just drag one line. So what you want to do is black cursor, select it all, object, group. And now when you click it, you're moving it all as one.
But it's not doing that. I just keep getting a moved thing. Object, transform.
That's what I, yeah, that's what I keep
doing. It's just moving the one.
Yeah, that's odd. Let's get it back down to one line. Delete 2 of those lines. Do you get to put how many? Yeah, that repeats it. Just a sec, I'll demonstrate that. Okay, select, transform, move. There we go. I think I got it. Let's do like 4 points, vertical.
Am I doing this?
And then maybe change the angle to center. Maybe like that, and choose copy. And then you just hit Command-D over and over to get it to repeat that last one. Alright, I don't know why it keeps popping up helpful windows to get my way, but that's looking real good there.
Yeah, but watch this.
Yeah, that's because it's got a fill on it.
There we go.
I need to demonstrate to everybody what went wrong there. I think we got it. You're going to want to select, whoopsie, the black cursor. Select it all. And then remove the fill. You can change your color and stroke if you wanted to, but you've got to get rid of the fill. Yeah, and then you're going to group it. When you're done with it, object.
I was talking about Command D and repeating it. Just a second, I'll wander around and get everybody else. What did I mean by that? After I did one transform like this, if I do object transform move and do it, then I can repeat it over and over. Because look, the transform option has something called transform again with a command key, a control key attached to it. And I can just keep hitting command D or control key, control D if you're on a PC, over and over and over to repeat it. If by chance your drawing looks like this, it's kind of cool, but it's not what we wanted. The reason is it's got a fill attached to it. And so I would select all the lines, and I would come over here to the fill option, to the very far uppermost box, and choose the red bar, remove the fill.
It's America.
Let's play with transform a little bit more, because move and copy are obviously not the only one. Maybe grab the rectangle tool. Let's draw something else. Oh, by the way, anybody need my eyeballs on your screen?
I do.
All righty.
I don't know what I'm doing.
Sometimes I don't either. Engage with art. No problem. You can create another artboard. Remember, if you hold the space bar down and then click on the screen, it turns into a hand to push the page. I'm going to draw another artboard so that I have more room to draw. That tool's the page with the crosshair in the corner, near the magnifying glass. And you just draw yourself a second page on the screen. You don't have to do that if you have room, right? But I want you to know how to do it. All right, now I'm going to draw something else. So I'm going to select maybe the rectangle tool. I'm just going to draw something. I don't care what it is. And then I'm going to choose object transform and just do the same thing, right? Object transform move. I do not want it to go 48 points, 141 points. Why don't I just do what I did before? Like 0 horizontal, 4 vertical, make it go off in some direction, click copy, and then start hitting Command D.
For vertical, you put a 0.
I put 4 for vertical.
Okay.
Now, for some reason, that one doesn't look as cool as that one did. Maybe if I made the stroke thicker on my box.
What about horizontal?
I'll have to look to see what that option is. Just a second. Let me draw another one. Object, transform, move. I don't see the horizon option. Oh, horizontal. How about make that 0?
Make that 0.
And then vertical 4. And then just click copy. And then Command D. Now, like I said, that's making it look real faint on my screen, so I'm going to try a thicker stroke. What I'm going to do is I'm going to use the black cursor to select the whole thing and to increase the stroke size to like 0.5. See if that looks better. Yeah, I kind of think that looks better. Well, moving isn't the only option. You can rotate. Why don't I type some text and then rotate it? Oh, and we should be grouping these things after we're done with it. So I'm going to select all of my boxes, object group, select all my boxes, object group. There's also a rotate option that might be fun. So I'm going to use a paintbrush to draw another squiggle or diagonal lines or something. Again, it defaulted to 1 point. Maybe that'll look good. So, do you see what I did? I used a paintbrush to draw some lines, a lightning bolt or something. I'm going to select it and choose Object, Transform, Rotate, and maybe rotate it 10 degrees or 5 degrees or something, and choose Copy, and then just keep doing that. Hit Command-D until it rotates as far as you want it to.
Hang on, I was trying to... I was busy doing the rectangle.
How are you doing that? Which tool did you use?
I used Rotate that time. I used a paintbrush to draw something, and then I used a black cursor to select it.
Yeah, I was just talking about the paintbrush.
Yep. And then object transform rotate and go like 5 degrees or 10 degrees or something. Choose copy again and then hit command D to rotate it like, you know, all 360 degrees. Oh, is it defaulting to inches on some people's screen?
That's why I've been.
Yeah, that would make it challenging. Okay. You can change the default units. Go to
Object Transform Rotate.
Illustrator Preferences Units. On the PC, there won't be an Illustrator menu, I don't think, so it's tucked somewhere slightly different. But Illustrator Preferences Units. And you can choose it to be points on all of them.
How did you turn it again?
It shows what you drew.
Yeah.
And then do command D.
Forgot what it was.
And then go to Object Transform Rotate.
That's what I did.
You hit OK instead of.
Yeah, and then choose copy. And then hit Command D, Control D until you're happy with how it looks. Get it to like go 360 degrees.
Okay, I'm gonna have to do this again.
You did it! Now you
can do that.
Yeah,
awesome.
That would have been so much easier for that. Yeah, you can go ahead and do that again.
Why am I not doing it?
And just delete all that.
Well, blank cursor, select, object, transform, object, transform, rotate. We don't want to rotate at 0 degrees, so how about 5 or 10?
Okay, I'll do 2. Yeah, I'll do 5.
And then click copy. And now, Control D that. Or Command D it. Yep.
There we go.
You can go as far as you want. Yeah, that's cool. All right, now yet again, it's got a fill on it, but in that case, maybe it looks good. You can stop it whenever you want. And then since it's got that white stuff on it, how about selecting the whole thing with your black cursor? Just like you were going to group it, right? Select the entire circle. And then remove the fill. Choose that red bar. There. Now it doesn't have that white stuff in it.
Can you... What was the circle done again?
What I did is I drew a wavy line or something with the paintbrush. Cursor to select it. Object, transform, rotate. 5 or 10 degrees. I don't know why defaults to 0. Click copy and then command D it until it's gone about 360 degrees around it.
That's cool.
That's cool. I'm so envious. I gotta show them that. I'm stealing your idea.
What did you do? Me?
No, yours is cool. Check this out, gang. If you take a box, go ahead and draw a box, put a fill on it this time, and then do the object, transform, move, just like we did before.
How do you put a fill on it?
You see this little box up here?
Oh, gotcha.
Yeah. So put a fill. It doesn't matter if it's white or whatever. And then object transform move just like we did before, maybe 0 horizontal, vertical 5, make it go down, choose copy. But then after it's gone one way for a while, change that direction. Object transform move, make it go a different direction. Then do it again, object transform move. I could go another way.
And I think I choose OK rather than copy. Oh, okay.
I just copied it and then Command-D it, and then it started going.
Oh, yeah, cool.
Great way to make illusions.
Yeah. I'm going to select it all, group it. I'm going to increase the stroke on that one because, again, it's too faint. Here we go. Yeah. Now some of these I haven't grouped together, so if I clicked on this circle and dragged, it would just pull one piece out and I'd be disappointed. So I'm gonna group that one as well. Black cursor, draw a line around it, group it, and I'm gonna try to do that to each one of these. Make sure that they're all grouped. Which part are you confused about? The rotate?
No, I already did the rotate.
Okay.
I'm looking at the square.
This one?
Yes.
What I did is I first started it moving in one direction, and then I changed its direction after a while. So, like, if I drew something and did object, transform, move, and then had it go a certain number of pixels for a while, like this. Then I just changed it, right? Then I went up here and chose object, transform, move, and had it go a different direction. And sent it off in another direction. And it looks cooler if they have a fill, and I forgot to put a fill on it. So I'm going to select them all and put some fill on it.
Oh, that looks sick.
They're a stack of cards or something.
Looks like that error, whatever messages that you get when your computer is on
like
virus.
Like beat solitaire.
Oh, yeah, yeah, that too. But yeah, I know what you mean when it freezes and you drag the dialogue around and it leaves a million copies of itself.
Yeah.
Okay, since the first project, I think we ought to go ahead and make that 2 weeks from today rather than one as previously planned, involves text. Why don't we play with text just one more little time? Go ahead and save this one, and let's make a new one, even though it's not an official assignment. This was Lecture B. And then do a save as and make a PDF out of it, and then close it. As a matter of fact, I do think we have an assignment that would be useful.
Can you turn this one into?
Yeah, turn this one into Dropbox B, assignment folder B. So there's an assignment E. Yeah, we're jumping out of order, but that's okay. this one's a good idea because it's preparation for doing like an ad slogan, something like that. So I'm going to click on assignments. Except I'm not in student mode, so it looks different for me. I fix that. So one more, eBurritoCat. There's two files you're going to want. You're going to want the picture itself. So I'm going to click on cat and save it and open it. There we go. And I want the doc. Let me close some of these extra files. That tells us what we're going to do with it. All right, here's what we're going to make. Would you like guacamole with your burrito, Cat?
Chipotle.
So we're going to make a new document with one artboard. I would make it not portrait mode, right? I'd make it landscape, but you can stretch out the artboard if you need to once you create it. And then we're going to get the cat. It says use file place, but I'd rather use copy and paste. I need to change my instructions to copy and paste. Because if you do file place, you have to give me the original cat as well, or else I won't be able to see it when you upload. Okay, so I'm going to go and download the cat. Already did, but why not again? And I'm just going to copy and paste. Edit, copy. Go into Illustrator, make a new document.
Can we also just drag and drop?
Yeah, I bet you can. Did that work?
It worked,
if you do that?
It's been working for me for the last few times.
I can't do it.
Well, that's a drag. I'm going to option spin out to make sure my page is like that. I may wind up resizing the page to fit the graphic I'm about to put on it. You can't drag and drop, that's a drag.
Not a drop.
Big jokes.
Oh, well, if you can't grab it to drag.
Well, I mean, I just, from the download section of the Chrome image or whatever, where it has that little where it says it's done downloading, I just grabbed that and dropped it into.
Oh, cool.
That's what I did with mine last time.
Oh, yeah, that works. You can't grab the picture.
Yeah, no.
You gotta grab the file. What she's talking about.
So if I went over here.
Like, download it again if you can't see it.
Yeah, download it again.
Or call it something else.
You go there.
Showing.
No,
you can grab it and drop it.
Oh, yeah. I can just grab it straight from Chrome?
Yeah.
All right.
Make your file or your page smaller. There you go.
Yeah.
You gotta still be able to see it. There you go. And then you just drag and drop it.
Learn something new. Thank you.
Yeah.
All right. Okay. Cat's too large or the artboard's too small. You can think of it one way or the other. So I'm just gonna grab the corner again and hold the shift key, shrink cat down a little bit. If the page doesn't match exactly, you can always reshape the page. How do we reshape the page? With the artboard tool, the one near the X-Acto knife. Choose the artboard tool and I can fit the page exactly to the picture. Or I could have stretched the cat out and changed its, you know, aspect ratio to fit.
Yeah.
Now we don't need to trace this. Why do I say that? Yeah, we could trace it, but you would not want to trace it as a black and white logo. You could trace it as a high fidelity photo, but there's no real reason to. That kind of reduces the resolution if you try to trace a photo. It reduces the file size of it, but okay. So anyways, I wish I hadn't done this. It's taking forever.
Oh,
for Pete's sake.
It looks so awful.
All right.
You know, and I might be able to mess with the threshold and stuff like that, but I'm afraid it'd take 20 minutes each time I did that, so I'm just going to undo that. All right, so what's the next part of the assignment? I'm going to choose the type tool, and I'm going to tell you not what to do. Don't grab the type tool and then click and drag. It looks like what you ought to do. But don't do it that way. Instead, just click the type tool, click and release. And yeah, that's too small, but we can increase the size of the font. Right now it's at 12 points. I'm going to just temporarily increase it to like 36 or 48 points, and then I'm going to stretch it out later to be even larger. And let's make it type. Go away. So I'm going to put some text that says, would you like guacamole? And then I'm going to add another line below that says, with your burrito cat. So, text tool, click and release, increase the font size if you want. Would you like, okay, black text on a black background is a bad choice, but we'll fix that. Would you like guacamole?
Guacamole?
Yeah, good question. Yeah, G-U-A-C-A-M-O-L-E, and I'm sure if we were really cool, we could put it, you know, a correct accent on it and whatever. But now I'm going to stretch my text out because that's pretty small, and I'd like for the text to be a little bit bigger. I'd like for the text to, like, you know, kind of fill up the top of it. Now, the most popular font, Lisa used to be, for doing the so-called memes was to choose Impact because it had a nice thick border around it. So I'm going to choose my font here, the black cursor, and go type, font, and I'm going to choose Impact. Now, if you don't want to use Impact, that's fine. Yeah, go ahead and spin the mouse, the cursor forever. All right, font. If I scroll down and choose Impact, there we go. That's the classical one. Now, why do we like that one? Because it's both got a fill and then a hard edge. But I'm going to stretch it out. I should be stretching it out, hitting Control Shift so that it remained, I mean, holding the Shift key so it remained its aspect ratio. A graphic designer would hate the fact that I'm changing the way the font looks by stretching it out and making it thicker, but that's okay. Now I need to add some more text down here that says, with your burrito cat. Rather than type more text in, I'm just going to copy this one. You may remember I said this, you may not, but if you have some text selected or any shape selected and you hold the Option key, the Alt key, and drag, it makes a copy of it. Fastest way of making a copy, faster than copy-paste. And then I'm just going to double click it so that I can edit the text with your burrito cat ? Yeah, feel free to actually be clever, unlike me. Now the next part of the instruction is to draw a logo. I'm not quite so sure at this point that I really care if you draw the logo, but I'd kind of like for you to give it a shot. But the other thing I want you to do before you go home is to put your own picture on there and your own text, right? Just make up anything you want. Go and find your own picture with Google and put your own text on it, right? Because you're more interesting than my burrito cat. But I am going to try to draw the logo. If you're interested in drawing the logo, oh, wait, we could do more with this, right? We might want to put a drop shadow on it. So black text is hard to read. Select the text lines. Set the fill of the text to white and the stroke to black. So if you put your text down and it looks like that, then you might change it. You might want to pick a font and change its size. Impact, 52 points is apparently one size that I picked. I wonder what that would look like if I chose the font and said I want it to be type size 52.
It can be any.
Ooh, I can't
choose
right? that. Yeah, you can pick whatever font you want. If you want to use the type menu to make, I mean, not the type menu, but the type panel to make fine adjustments, you find that under Window, Type, and you can pick, like, Character. And it's actually open over here. And so I could try changing the size and stuff like that right there. Seems to me like 52, like my document suggests, is too small. Did I misspell guacamole? All right. Start to look weird after a while. Does that ever happen to you? You look at a word, and the longer you look at it, the longer the wronger. How about I speak good English? Okay.
I don't speak English really good.
Me fail English? That's impossible.
We use one brain.
There we go. Okay, so if I wanted to draw a Chipotle logo down at the bottom, you're going to want a rounded rectangle with some red text on it. So, under the regular rectangle and the ellipses and stuff like that is rounded rectangle. So you could draw a rectangle. And notice it's got these itty-bitty little circles in here that you can change the roundness of it. Do you see what I mean? It's got these corners. Once you add a rounded rectangle, you can pick one of the corners and make it more circular. And then you're going to want to make it with a red fill and no stroke. So I'm going to choose a red fill. It's already set to no stroke on mine, but it might not have been. All right, I have a red shape on which to put my white text. So I'm going to grab the T tool, type my Chipotle. Now that's the wrong size and the wrong color, but I can make it white, and I can pick a better font. I think my document suggests a font. Let me go look. Oh, how about I not give one? Great. Okay. Well, I'll customize until I find what looks good. Type, font, doesn't really matter. All right, that one looks good to my eyes, not really being a type master. The one that I just chose was type, font, avenir, light. and now I'm going to shape it, change its shape to fit inside my oval or vice versa. Then we probably want to group those two things together. I need to zoom out and make sure the placement of everything's good. Okay, now this would work for our project, right? Except you're not going to turn this in as your project because we did it together. We could put a drop shadow on the text to make it look a little bit fancier. How do you put a drop shadow? You select the text, do Effect, Stylize, Drop Shadow, and then preview and play with the options. So I selected my text and I chose Stylize, Drop Shadow, Preview, and I can kind of see that there's a drop shadow there. And then I selected the other text and I just clicked Apply Drop Shadow, so to repeat my last settings. All right. That really is enough, whether or not you draw the logo, but I want you to go and find your own picture and make your own illustration with your own text. Or if you're going to work on your project, that's just as good. Make good use of your time now. Make it your own.
I accidentally submitted the one that I wasn't finished on, but this should be the last of it, right?
This is the last homework assignment, yeah. Okay. Or in-class assignment, excuse me. This is the last part of the lecture.
Cool. Like, you know, the first one that I,
all right.
Replace.
So I'm going to save it as lecture E, then I'm going to save as to make a PDF and submit them.
Mentioned something about the logo. What was it? Was it like for project one?
Yeah, for your project one. What do we want to do for project one? I'm going to upload a document with about 6 different choices, and if you want to do those projects, good. If you feel like it, you can do a different project. Let's upload those choices right now.
Right now I'm just going to be using my logo and then using the word on it and then have that as like an album. See if that might work. If that's okay.
Yeah. I'd like for you to go ahead and submit it soon so that if I'd like for you to do a little bit more to it, then I can give you suggestions.
But you do like the logo how I did it?
Well, I'm not going to change it, but I might have suggestions for you. Because if you just take artwork and just put a little piece of text on it, I don't know. That's right.
Mine is, I just changed the color because that was my kind of color I was wanting it to be.
Okay. Remember, I'd like for it to be something that took you more than 5 minutes. Take that into account.
I am doing this all wrong again.
I asked my dad if I could make him, like, recreate his logo because this was his logo.
Yeah.
And so I asked him if I could recreate it. And so I came up with this so far.
Yeah.
And 'cause he said that not everybody would probably know that this is a quill pen, and so.
Well, I bet most people would, but yeah.
Yeah, so yeah. With like a feather pen, because they
cool.
thought about that at first.
Yeah.
Because Harry Potter, they like Harry Potter.
Yeah.
And so it ties into all of this. I was wondering if you had like any suggestions on anything else I can do with it.
A drop shadow on the text would look real bad, I think, with the font that you chose.
I think so,
I
too.
I don't think that
well,
you'd want to do that. It's
yeah.
actually looking like a complete project to
okay.
me.
And
it,
then
it really is.
I also started on doing like a business card type for
oh,
it.
Oh, cool.
Because it is pens that they make.
Right.
They roll pens. I thought for their business card, what they could do is when giving them the business cards, they can test out the pen on the card itself.
Yeah. Yeah, that would be cool.
Okay.
That would be totally cool.
Sweet. Awesome. Ooh.
Yeah, totally cool.
Which one was the scale? I forgot what it was called last time when it was pixelated before.